Yeah, I know you might be thinking, if we're talking about an accountant, right? I mean, can an accountant really be killer? I mean, sometimes we think, oh, we got a, a killer attorney, or maybe, I don't know, some other sort of killer martial arts teacher or something like that. But can an accountant really be killer? And, the truth of the matter is that most of them totally aren't, unfortunately, and but they absolutely can be. And, what's the difference between like a killer accountant and just sort of a, bean counting bookkeeper or something? And it really comes down to this. I mean, look, the vast majority of people that are doing accounting, it's almost like they don't understand really what the numbers even mean. It's almost like, they don't get that there's like out there in reality, there's things that are happening in reality, and those things are deriving, the sort of accounting numbers, right? So there's sales transactions going on, there's expense transactions going on, and those things are sort of creating the financials, right? But if you just sort of get in there and you sort of mealy-mouth around the numbers, that's not going to really make a big difference for you. You have to actually understand the fundamental business. So if you want to be a killer accountant or you want to have a killer accountant, it has to be someone that actually understands what the hell is going on with these numbers. And the way that you do that is by actually starting to understand how business works and then creating a service as an accountant where you're actually making a tangible difference. Like if a client works with you, right? Let's say you're going to work with a construction company. I mean, are they actually going to make more in sales from working with you? Are they going to make more in profits? Are you going to help them expand margins? Are you going to help them understand their costs better so they can reduce them, so they can further increase prices? Like, are you going to give them more timely reporting so they can make better decisions? Are you going to help them save money on taxes? Are you going to restructure legal entity, set up retirement, implement the Trump tax cuts and all that stuff? Like, are you going to do something that's going to make them more money? At the end of the day, most people see their accountants as someone who's just sort of doing accounting. They don't see them as someone that's helping them make more money. But if you're a killer accountant, you're basically somebody who, whenever a client works with you, they go and brag to their friends about you because you're literally making them more money. You're helping them make more profit. You're helping them take more money home. Now, whether that's from an accounting service, like being an outsourced CFO and helping them expand sales, reduce expenses, increase margins, or it's on the tax side and helping them, actually reduce the taxable liability, going forward, and if you can do anything in the past, doing that as well. So if you're just sort of reconciling bank statements, and you're just sort of preparing the books and doing bookkeeping and you're just sort of preparing 1040s and 1120s and you think that that's really gonna get you there. It's just not. It's never going to get you out of commodity pricing, right? I mean, you should be charging. I always say you should be charging no less than $500 a month if you're doing any accounting service. Generally, over $1,000 a month. People say, "Oh my gosh, I don't have anybody over 300. How could this possibly be $300 a month?" I mean, if you're working with crappy clients or you're underselling yourself, but more likely, you're underselling yourself. But sometimes you're underselling yourself because what you have, there's no real value there. It's just the basics. And you have to have more than the basics if you really want to jack up the prices or work with somebody larger. And, on the tax side, same thing. I mean, if you're just doing preparation, but you're not, showing people how to save money, right? I can't tell you, I'm not even getting thousands and thousands, hundreds of thousands. Actually, I'll just say this. Millions of returns are filed every year with people overpaying by 10, 20, 30, $40,000 a year. And are you really helping them pay as little as they legally can? And are you getting paid for that? Are you getting paid for that separately? And if you're not, why not? I mean, here's the funny thing, right? Here's a little dirty little secret. Most small business owners think that the accountants are helping them save money on taxes, but they're not. They're just prepping the returns, sending it over. They're just beep, 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 boop, 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 sending it over. They're not actually doing it, right? They're not actually helping them save. They're just sort of entering in numbers. I say they're sort of pecking in the numbers like a parakeet pecking the keyboard. But if you're actually helping them save, then you should be charging for that separately and in addition to the preparation. So look, whether you're just getting started, in accounting and you want to start your own business, or you've been around forever, if you're not hitting some of these numbers, at least charging, $5,000 to $7,500 for tax planning separate from the preparation, $1,000 for individual returns, $2,000 for the business, and we're doing at least $1,000 a month on any accounting work, if we're not in those ranges, then, we've got some serious work to do.